Hello there, my name is Sanjay and welcome to this video by Sanrusa Consultancy. I am going to take you through the process of installing ODI 12C Enterprise Edition with standalone and JEE agent. ODI 12C installation has 6 steps. The first one is JDK installation, then middleware installation, repository creation, WebLogic configuration, and then starting node manager, WebLogic and agent, and then we are going to test the agent. ODI 12C needs JDK 7 and above. We are going to install JDK 8. Make sure you install it from Oracle web page. You need to have Oracle login and accept their terms and conditions. We are installing ODI 12C on Windows, so we need a JDK for Windows. Once the file is downloaded in the user downloads folder, it's better to move it to a new folder. Make sure the new folder where you are moving that JDK file, the folder name does not have a space into it. So I am going to create a new folder called Java. I will paste that file in this new folder. Double click on the .exe file to start the JDK kit. Click on next button. Make sure to change the folder to the new folder which we just created. Keep the subfolder name same, that is JDK 1.8.0.11. In between, it will ask you
for the folder where JRE will be installed. Make sure to change that to the folder which we created. Do not let it create that JRE subfolder and install JRE files in program files folder. So go to the Java folder which we created and create a new subfolder with the same subfolder name JRE 1.8.0_111 and install the JRE files over there. Wait for the final successful message. After JDK is installed, the next step is to change the Java home environmental property. For that, go to My Computer, Advanced Properties, and click on the system variables. I already have a Java underscore home variable defined. If you don't have it in your computer, click on New and create a new variable called Java underscore home. And in the variable value, put the directory where JDK bin subfolder is installed. Next, we are going to install Oracle Fusion Middleware 12c. If you Google for download Oracle Data Integrated 12c, it will take you to Oracle web page. On the same web page, there is a link to install Oracle Fusion Middleware infrastructure for all platforms. Click on that link. Provide your username and password. It will launch Oracle Fusion Middleware 12c installer. Fusion Middleware installer needs a new Oracle home folder. This folder should not have any subfolder or file under it. So I am going to create a new folder called Oracle underscore home. Congratulations, Oracle Fusion Middleware has been installed successfully.
You can verify the files by going to the Oracle home directory we just created.
Next step is to create repository in database. These are basically schemas which will be used by ODI. The Fusion Middleware folder which we created has rcu.bat file under Oracle Home, Oracle Common, Bin folder. Click on that and it will launch repository creation utility. Congratulations, the schemas have been created successfully. In order to validate, you can log in to Toad or SQL developer, give username as dev_stb, and the password which you gave while creating the schemas in RCU. Once you are there, go to the schemas and look at the list of schemas. You should get all the schemas which we created through RC. Now we will configure Oracle WebLogic server and we will also create ODI domain in Fusion Middleware. Also we will configure ODI standalone and JEE agent. Go to the Oracle home directory which we created while installing Fusion Middleware. In that Oracle home directory, go to the Oracle Common and then Common and then Bin directory. Double click on config.cmd file. It will open the Fusion Middleware configuration wizard. Click on create new domain and then browse and create a new folder which should not have any subfolder are filed in it. I am going to create a new folder called ODI domain. So all my files related to WebLogic configuration are going to be created in that ODI domain directory. Click on next button and select all the ODI related artifacts, like select ODI console, ODI agent, ODI standalone co-located agent. It will ask for application domain, which is same. You provide username and password for WebLogic server. This is username and password for admin console. This is where you have to do RCU configurations. I have installed my database on localhost, so I'm going to put hostname as localhost. Dev underscore stb is the schema we created during RCU creation. Click on get RCU configurations. Wait for the success message. This has been successfully done. We can go to next step. Here, click on test selected connections and it will test all the connections. In the credential screen, give username and password for supervisor. This is the username and password which we created during RCU creation, the step number 3. We also have to create a new credential for ODI that I'm giving name as ODI underscore credentials underscore 1 and keep username same as WebLogic and same password. Click on next. Make sure you select all four of these, that is admin server, node manager, topology and system component. It will take you to the admin server first. I have localhost as admin server, so I'm going to select localhost. To username and password for node manager, I am going to keep it same as username and password of admin console. Congratulations, the WebLogic server has been configured. After the WebLogic is configured, if you go to Oracle Home folder, which we created during Fusion Middleware installation, in that go to User Projects subfolder and Domains. We will see our new
domain created there. In my case, it was ODI domain, and I see ODI domain folder there. Next step is to start the service. In the starting sequence, we should first start the node manager. Node manager is located in the domain bin folder. Double click on start node manager.cmd file to start the node manager. After node manager, we should start WebLogic server. Click on start weblogic.cmd. Wait for the message server state changed to running. Open the browser, put machine name colon 7001 / console. In my case, it is localhost, so I put localhost 7001 console. And this is going to open the admin server. Put the username and password. Navigate to the service list and click on control tab. Check the ODI server one and start. Now we are going to define the standalone agent and JEE agent in ODI Studio. Start the ODI Studio. Go to the topology, right click the agent. Make sure to put the name as shown here. Oracle Agent 1 is standalone agent. And Oracle agent is JEE agent. This is case sensitive. In case of JEE agent, the port number is 15101. Define the logical agents. The next step is to start the standalone agent. For that, go to the same folder, domain bin. Put the same command as shown here in this screen, agent.cmd name equal to Oracle DI agent 1. The name is case sensitive, so make sure you put the same name and wait for the success message.
To validate that ODI standalone agent has started successfully, open a browser and put the address as shown in this screen. If you get the same message that indicates that ODI standalone agent has started. Next step is to start ODI JEE agent. The final step is to test the standalone and JEE agent. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you found it useful, please subscribe to our channel and we will bring you more such useful videos. Thank you.